So why are we still sitting here waiting until we die? We're waiting, and I mean, the time has already come. We've escaped the famine. People are dying. We can't go back. Can't stay here at the gate. People, and we're dying if we stay here. The only option that we have, y'all, is to go forward and to step out on faith. When the leprous men took the step of faith, they realized that we got to get up from here, y'all. We got to
come on, we got to get up.
We got to do something.
Come on now. Come on now.
Mary, this is a done deal. We understand we can't. Going back is not an option.
Y'all need to know that too.
Come on, Pastor. Going back is not an option. Tell you what, I knew it. Come on. I've been delivered for 15 years, but the dope game been changed. Going back is not an option, kid. There's some youngsters out there spit my throat as soon as I hit the corner. It done changed. So going back is not an option. And now that I'm here, Carol, ain't no sense of me just getting up every Sunday when the sun's shining and the breeze blowing and I'm coming to church and I ain't doing nothing to impact the kingdom of God, so I can't stay here. I've got to move forward. I've got to go ahead and see what the end is going to be. The same thing that terrifies us in the fears of the unknown. Right. It's the same realm of the spirit that is calling for us. Jesus. Baby, don't you know if you don't perform some of the things that God has created you to perform, there is a void in the earth because you're not doing what God created you to do.
All right.
My God.
Good work. Wow, we're still sitting here waiting until we die.
Why?
Jesus.
All right.
When the leprous men finally got up and began to move forth and pursue the unknown.
Come on,
how many have some reservations about the unknown? That's the thing, you know, I had this little thought about, you know, people keep telling me I need to open this business, I need to start doing this, I need to open a daycare, I need to start a bakery, I need to, you know, I need to do, people tell, and they give you all the key, you know, people were willing to help you, they were to tell you who they know, they got the hookups, they got the resources, all you got to do is move forward, and you're hesitant, and you're reluctant about moving forward. The Bible says that when they got up and they began to move forward into the unknown, that when they got to the place that they were terrified of and terrified of what the outcome may be, they were terrified of whether or not they would be successful, where they would live or whether they would die. When they got to the place that terrified them, the Bible says that when they got there was nobody there that they could eat. All the wine they could drink. They had silver and they had gold. They had royal clothing and linen. And they just began to pack up and eat as much as they could eat and drink as much wine as they could drink and get as much gold and money and rubies as they could. The Bible said that they took some home and they hid it.
Come on.
And they went back again and they stocked up again.
My God.
The entire kingdom of what they feared of the enemy. That once they began to pursue, God created a sound.
My God.
He created a sound, and the sound to the enemy's ear was like horses and chariots were coming.
My God, come on.
And the Bible said that the enemy said, oh my God, they didn't hide the Hittites and the Iranian and the army, and I hear an army coming. And it went, but they said, and they fled.
Yes.
And they left everything within. Can I say to you today, the same enemy, the same fear, the same thing that's terrorizing you and got you holding back and not moving forward in the things of God, that if you just make a step, if you just begin to pursue, God will release a sound that will terrorize your enemy, that will move all of your opposition, that will open up the doors of favor in your life. If you just move forward into the things of God, God will create a sound.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Several years ago, God had put on my heart, and it was for about 3 years. It was heavy on my heart, and I hadn't done it. And he had put on my heart to open a boys' home. And I mean, I couldn't escape it. I didn't do it, but I couldn't escape it. I went to the training, then I stopped. I did something else happened, and I stopped. Something else happened, and I stopped. Years later, over 2 years later, I go back to the office to inquire about the license, and the lady tell me, I still have your application in my desk. It's been 2 years. I still have the case. It never even went back to the file. You made such an impression on me. I knew we had to have you. I was hoping you'd come back. I never moved your application. So all the things that would have expired, I didn't even have to go through again. And so they expedited me all through the process. But wait. When the very first day that I stepped forward and publicly spoke what the Lord had given me to do, when I released it to the church, I had a list, 2 pages of things that I needed. Everything from t-shirts to a van to drive. I mean, everything in between. The beds, the furniture, the whole 9 yards. I needed everything. Yeah. When I stepped forward and released what God had called me to walk in, before I could put down the microphone, people were coming and plagued, and here's a watch. I'll buy you a washer and dryer. I'll buy you a van. I'll get your pool table. I'll take them shopping. I'll decorate the rooms. I'll get you 4 sets of bunk beds. I mean, everything that I had fear of. Everything that I was terrorized by, because I didn't have this, and I didn't have that, and I didn't have this. But as soon as I took a step of faith, God created a sound that caused the people's hearts to give and the soul into what he had called to do. I'm just trying to tell somebody today that the very fear and terror of the unknown, you can't let it hold you back. All the gifts and all the talents, all the skill and all the anointing, all the grace that we're connected to, and Dr. Cassandra, this ministry is moving nationwide. And it's small, so we can get into some places that some mega ministries can't just squeeze in like that. Doors are opening, avenues are pouring up. People are longing for the anointing that rests in this house. And everybody connected is connected to the anointing that's on her life. And so whatever it is, because God put her here with a specific passion, and that is the passion to birth your gifts out. That's where her anointing becomes so strong, because she's birthing the gifts out of so many other people.
Jesus.
There is no reason for us to sit here connected to all that we're connected to, with all the favor and all the anointing that's on this house, and not fulfill everything that God has purposed for our life. And so, my question for you, as I take my seat, is why are we still sitting here,
yes, Lord,
waiting until we die?
Goodness.
Ask yourself, make it personal. Why am I still sitting here waiting until I die? Why? What is it that I have that I'm sitting on that God has put into my heart, and I'm still sitting here and waiting? But why am I still sitting here? I know where my options are. I know what I can't do. I know I can't go back. I know I can't remain. So I have to move forward. So why am I still sitting here? Think about, what is it that's challenging me? What is it that's trying to be my opposition? What giant do I need to conquer so that I can move forward in the things of God? Why am I still sitting here waiting until I die? But we thank God today that through the anointing teaching of the Conquering the Giant series, this message today was just to encourage us to move on in applying the things that we have gotten over the last 2 months. There is no way that there will not be some movement in my life after getting the clear instruction, the clear word, and everything that I needed to move forward, there is no reason why I shouldn't conquer every giant that has stood before me. Amen. So we give God glory today. Yeah. Yeah. We give him honor, and we give him praise.